especially in the Asian countries, especially in India. So health and education. So I thought might as well work on healthcare, which is a very important aspect of social well-being. And in India, we need it very much. And I selected this small town. I thought how the government healthcare facilities are working here in this small town. And so healthcare is one of the vital issues of every human being. We all need a very good healthcare system in our country. But it is a big question that who gets where and how. And Jalpaiguri district or Jalpaiguri town, and we need the distribution of healthcare facilities in the town, what people are getting and how the available facilities are utilized and how the people are using the government as well as the private healthcare facilities. Now I have surveyed a small area in this town and almost of 145 households and a total of 745 total population of among which there are 365 female and male population and 380 female population. And I have surveyed the disease pattern and checked into through a proper questionnaire, and I have looked into the cardiovascular, endocrine, malignancy and all these main diseases, and I have seen that in India people are suffering from chronic as well as infectious and communicative diseases also. So there is a double burden of disease. In the sense, like poor people are not free from the chronic and the chronic diseases. It is not the point that only they are suffering from communicative and infectious diseases. They are also suffering from chronic diseases, which is very high. And there are very high cases of tuberculosis as well as diabetic, which is again a chronic disease. Then I have looked into all these. I have percentage wise figure. I have seen that very high fever cases were reported. It was in the month of winter I surveyed. And high cases of asthma, high cases of bronchial patients, respiratory patients were a very high percentage. I mean, no less. And then again, these blood pressure high and chronic cardiovascular diseases were very high. Now, if the disease pattern shows that it is so high, then the government and the healthcare facilities also should be very good quality to check into this fact that if there is a demand of healthcare, there should be a supply also. But here I find a big lack of government healthcare facilities. There are very there is one government hospital in this town which does not cater to all the healthcare needs of the people. Like for example, these are the classified diseases. I mean, I've classified into class and into like degenerative, infectious, communicable, and other diseases. I've classified it, and then the data I have put it accordingly. Like degenerative is how much percent infectious. You can see there is a high infectious disease percent. These are high accident cases. Others are also high. Respiratory cases are also very high. So this is a disease pattern which is emerging out of the study. And then I have studied into the utilization pattern where 193 cases are there, among which high utilization is of government facilities, 78.7%. That shows that people are, they can't afford private. So they are going to the government hospitals. But the government facilities are not enough to cater to the need of the people. So here I see that the private is functioning also, which is 13.47, and but there no treatment is again 6.74%. So this is I can infer from this that since our policies, the government policies regarding healthcare, the investment is very less, and this is a reflection that the government is not investing at all, much at all, in the healthcare sector. So the demand is increasing, but the supply is not there. So in that event, the gap which is created is fulfilled by the private. The private is entering very fast in these aspects. And what is the private doing? They're catering to the needs of the rich people who can afford. The poor people, which is a huge number in India, they can't afford these private facilities. So this is my question, or my conclusion, that what should we do? The government, my suggestion would be government should look into the government facilities, should set up a referral system so that the private, so that the poor people, I am talking about the poor people who need healthcare, should go to, can go to the hospitals and get proper treatment. Thank you very much.